We're going to show you the top 15 foods that take calcium out of your arteries and the studies behind it. We're starting now. I'm going to go over the top 10 benefits of vitamin K2 and whether the studies in the real world actually support this or not, or if people are just hyping stuff up to sell their supplements. And then we're going to go over the top 15 foods that contain this. The crazy thing is our diets are more processed than ever. Heart disease is up higher than ever. I saw a paper that essentially said compared to 100 years ago, there is 90% less magnesium in our foods. And that's probably true for things like vitamin K2 as well. We have less nutritious foods and more bad calories every single day. Our diabetes is high. So we're going to go over 15 great foods to reverse that calcium from your arteries. Here's the top 10 benefits of vitamin K2. Number 10, improved exercise performance. Some studies suggest that vitamin K2 might influence exercise performance by improving mitochondrial function. The mitochondria are our energy center in our cell. Number 9, early research indicates vitamin K2 may help reduce skin aging and improve skin elasticity. That could be a good one. Number 8, anti-inflammatory properties. If you want a natural anti-inflammatory, go over my videos on turmeric and curcumin, but vitamin K2 has been shown to help with that as well. Number 7, supports brain health. There is evidence suggesting that vitamin K2 is neuroprotective and can help in Alzheimer's disease. There is research looking at Alzheimer's disease and supplementing with vitamin K2, and it is promising thus far. Number 6, diabetes management. The European Journal of Pharmacology has shown that vitamin K2 may improve insulin sensitivity and helps with the management of diabetes. Very promising. Improved dental health. The role of vitamin K2 in dental health has been well studied, particularly in remineralizing teeth. That means making bad teeth healthier. There is a dentist, Dr. Weston Price. Look that guy up. He's got hundreds of studies. He even wrote a book about this, publishing his studies. He essentially said patients who take adequate K2 will not have cavities. That's a bold claim. I'm not necessarily validating that, but that's what he said. Number 4, reduced risk of cancer. Some studies like the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition have found that as you take vitamin K2, certain cancers decrease, especially a study with prostate cancer. However, that's not my area of expertise. I'm not going to focus on that. Number 3, supports blood clotting. Vitamin K2 is well established and well documented in the blood clotting cascade. It is needed for the normal functioning of vitamin K2. We'll talk about what to do if you're on blood thinners potentially, because you don't want too healthy of a blood clot system. And hey, this is in the news more and more every day. I'm not going to get into why blood clots are so popular now. I don't want these videos demonetized, but I'm sure I'll get it in the comments because there's always a few. Number 2, cardiovascular health. A significant amount of research in the Journal of Nutrition supports the role of vitamin K2 in reducing arterial calcification. Bone in our arteries decreases and our heart health is better. And we're going to go over the newer research on that in a second. And number 1, bone health. This is so well proven, but vitamin K2 is critical in bone health. The Journal of Bone and Mineral Research have demonstrated that vitamin K2 improves bone mineral density, less fracture risk, less osteoporosis. The way I like to think about it is vitamin D puts calcium in your blood. And you need vitamin K2 to take it from the blood and put it in the bone. If you have just vitamin D going into the blood, then that calcium can get in a lot of different places. That vitamin K2 is needed to get it into the proper places. And unfortunately, one of those places might be the arteries. Reversing arterial calcification, particularly using vitamin K2, is a hot topic. There's a lot of good evidence. Some of it is very proven. Some of it not perfectly proven. Here's a summary of vitamin K2. Vitamin K2 is well studied for activating something called matrix GLA protein, or MGP, which inhibits calcification in the arteries. A study in the Journal of Nutritional Biochemistry suggests that vitamin K2 can reduce vascular calcification. When I say reduce, it's not taking an 8-year-old and making their arteries like a 20-year-old, but it's preventing it from getting worse. I think it's well established that it prevents it from getting worse, but it doesn't necessarily reverse it to like a 20-year-old. I go over this in my peripheral neuropathy videos, my skincare videos. It's impossible to reverse aging. As much as commercials like to tell you so and supplement sellers like to tell you so, it's impossible. We can improve the quality of our lives, but we can't go back in time, unfortunately. That's where we kind of draw the line on the sensationalism. Vitamin K2 has been proven to activate matrix GLA protein. It prevents calcium from depositing in arterial walls and helps that calcium get into the bones, which is exactly what we want. It does those nine other things we talked about. So a good way to think about it is with your proper vitamin D, with your proper vitamin K2, I like to support omega-3 fatty acids and magnesium as well. Everything's working a lot better. The crazy thing is our diets are horrible now. In America, in Europe, in the East, India, in China as well, pretty much all the places that people are watching these videos, our diets are terrible. Our calories in the 1950s were like 2,500 calories. Now they're almost 4,000 in the developed world, but our nutrition is going down. Most of those calories are from sugar, from grains, for simple snacks that are cheap and easy to store. Current research suggests that 90 to 180 micrograms of vitamin K2 are needed in our diet, but no one's getting that. It's said that the deficiency is probably greater than 50%, probably much higher than that, I would estimate. This is just not something that's well studied. Vitamin K2 is such a hot topic. I'm gonna go over the top 15 foods that you can start eating, and I make the list myself. So I go from least practical and least vitamin K2 to most practical and most vitamin K2. So this is my top 15 list in order. And we're gonna standardize all dosages to 100 grams. I'm gonna give you the content per 100 grams of food. Number 15, dark chicken meat. The thighs, the drumsticks. This is a lower end source of vitamin K2. You get 9 micrograms per 100 gram portion. Number 14, butter. This is a hot topic. Butter was bashed as being unhealthy. In my egg video, I go over the studies, but essentially, butter is healthier than we think. It got so much blame. Butter contains approximately 15 micrograms of vitamin K2. So some studies now actually show that butter could be good for your arteries rather than bad. Isn't that crazy? And this is kind of proven by the French diet. France, for example, has higher rates of butter eating and less artery and heart health issues, whereas India has the highest amount of vegan and vegetarianism, but they have some of the highest heart and vascular disease levels in the world. I'm not saying that's the only reason, but something to think about. Tell me in the comments if I've got it wrong or if I got it right. Number 13, chicken liver. Chicken liver is a good source of vitamin K2. It has approximately 15 micrograms per 100 grams. I personally don't like eating chicken liver. I think that's gross. So let's move on to number 12, whole milk. Whole milk does have 1 to 2 micrograms of K2 per 100 milliliters. You're not gonna drink like 100 cups of milk. So it's low on the list. Number 11, sauerkraut. Fermented foods like sauerkraut contain vitamin K2. Generally, they have about 5 micrograms per 100 grams. Is this practical to eat? Not really. Don't worry, we're getting to some good ones that are practical. Number 10, ground beef. Non-grass-fed ground beef contains 8.1 micrograms per 100 grams. This is a good source. Ground beef has a lot of B vitamins, a lot of other vitamins, but not the highest amount of vitamin K2. Number 9, chicken breast has about 9 micrograms per 100 grams. This is a more common food to eat, a pretty good source. If you eat a chicken breast, you're gonna get a decent amount of your day's vitamin K2. Number 8, pork chops. This actually has a much higher amount than I thought, but vitamin K2 is present in about 35 micrograms. So 35 out of your 90 to 180, that's a good amount. Number 7, hard cheeses, especially like cheddar cheese. Cheese is a great source of vitamin K2. 100 grams contain 10 or more micrograms. So you're not gonna get all the way there, but it can help. Number 6, soft cheeses like brie, like gouda. I love these on some crackers. Didn't justify it to my wife, but it's higher in vitamin K2 than hard cheeses. Look at this amount, we're getting into the good ones now. 75 micrograms per 100 grams. So eating a little bit of soft cheese gets you most of the way there to your daily level. Number 5, fermented dairy products. So kefir, yogurt, Greek yogurt, this varies, but eating some Greek yogurt, that can definitely get you a large chunk of the way there. It can contribute 20, 30, 40 micrograms or more. Number four, grass-fed beef. Grass-fed beef. This is a little bit healthier than non-grass-fed beef. I have a whole video that goes over grass-fed versus non-grass-fed. But this has, rather than like the 9 micrograms in the non-grass-fed, the grass-fed has about 35 micrograms per 100 grams. That's pretty good. Number three, this is perhaps my favorite and my most practical, except for 1 and 2 just have so much vitamin K2 in there. Number three for me is eggs. Egg yolk specifically provides a large amount of vitamin K2. It has approximately 33 micrograms per 100 grams. Now, the crazy part is health fanatics recommend just egg whites, but the egg yolk, look at that vitamin K2. That's great for your arteries. I go over this in my egg video. Eggs unfairly get bashed. The studies are phenomenal all around. There was some BS propaganda and clear corrupted studies in the past. I go over that in my egg video and I detail some of that. But eggs, in my opinion, I eat them every day. My kids eat them every day. I think it's a great decision. If I'm wrong, tell me about it. Number two, this actually has the most, but I'm not going to practically eat it. I couldn't justify putting it at number one. But the richest source of vitamin K2 is goose liver pate or foie gras. I'm not French. My wife speaks French, so I don't know if I said that correctly. My French viewers, tell me how bad I am. But it is not commonly consumed due to ethical and health considerations. I don't even know if I ever ate goose liver pate. I wouldn't know what it looks like. That's why it's not number one. But it has 370 micrograms per 100 grams. So just eating a quarter of this gets you all the way to your level. But number one, boom, and this is the secret choice. This is the most practical one, extremely beneficial, natto. Natto is fermented beans. So essentially a bacteria ferments these beans. It's kind of like a soybean, but it contains 1,100 micrograms per 100 gram unit. That's a crazy amount. So just eating a little bit of natto gets you most of the way there. Pros are there's the clear benefits that I talked about with vitamin K2. You can make some natto at the beginning of the week and just eat it a couple times a week, and you're pretty much good for the week. One time in the video, somebody told me if you freeze it, it ruins the vitamin K2 content, but I can't verify that anyway. I looked through every study on PubMed. I looked everywhere. It's just like a vague rumor. It seems to have been overblown. Tell me if I'm missing it. If you can find some research about freezing natto and it destroys the vitamin K2, tell me those sources and I will gladly update this video, but I cannot find that anywhere. The pros are it helps with all the 10 benefits we talked about. It's the highest, most practical amount. You can store it. The downsides are some people hate the taste. It's slimy, it's gooey, it has terrible texture. It gets bashed in the videos, but realistically, just eat a little bit, get your vitamin K2, treat it as a supplement. If you're on blood thinners, so if you're a healthy person, this is the risk of blood clotting. If you're a healthy person, you can take this. It's a natural food. God put it on this planet for us to eat. That's a good way to think about it. Theoretically, anything could happen to anybody. There's always that risk, but realistically, there's no risk to eating this natto, even though it's such high amounts. And then number two, if you're on a blood thinner, check with your doctor. So if you're on warfarin, Coumadin, if you're on Xarelto, all that kind of stuff, check with your doctor, check your bleeding levels. That's not something I want to get involved with, but that is a consideration if you're on AFib.
This is a chart of the top 20 vitamin K2 foods, and ideally diet is the way to get it. So there's a Japanese fermented dish called natto. That's number one, and I have a whole video going about natto and the supplement natto kinase. That's the natto kinase supplement right there. But cheeses as well, goose liver, chicken liver are also high options. You can see the first couple options have the most vitamin K2, but also eggs, Gouda cheeses, goose leg, pepperoni have some, salami has some. So you can see the deli meats, a lot of meats have vitamin K2. So vitamin K2 is a fatty supplement. It's a fatty vitamin that you can get in through your diet. It's also in butter. I have videos about butter as well. So MK4 and MK7, the MK4 lasts shorter, but potentially has better absorption. Or MK7 lasts a little bit longer, but potentially has worse absorption. So getting it through your diet, this is foods that will give you a nice mix of it. So I'm not picking one vitamin K or the other. This is a good option to get it through diet. So as a supplement, you want your 90 to 360 milligrams per day. And a lot of supplements now, in a practical sense, you could get it both with all the mixtures of MK4 and MK7 with your vitamin D as well. So you could get one of the combo ones, and I link those below. But taking a look at all the studies, the average doses were 90 to 360 micrograms. And most of the studies now are very encouraging, especially for bone health and for limiting arterial calcification. It might not reverse it all the way, but it can help you stay healthier and just work it in as part of your supplement routine. That's the best way to go about it, in my opinion.
That's the most important one. Tell me if I missed anyone, but one thing is, for my vegans and vegetarians, there are supplements that there was no green vegetables on that list. So a supplement might be worth taking. I go over that in my videos below. That could be something that's really important. I think about India, and I've seen studies on this. India has the highest amount of vegan and vegetarian populations, and their heart risk and their artery risk is pretty high compared to other nations. Tell me if I'm getting that wrong. What do you think about that? Check out my reversing artery videos and my best home remedies, how to reverse your artery disease.